In this video, I'm going to show you the recreation of an electric battery which was used in ancient India. This battery was described by a sage called Agastya, who lived at least 4,000 years ago. And what I'm making is according to what's being described in the ancient text called Agastya Samhita. This text talks about using an earthen pot as a container and uses two types of metals, copper and zinc. Here I have copper and here I have zinc. So this is how the setup looks. If I test this with a voltmeter, you can see that there is no charge. The text mentions that I should add sawdust into the container. Now, once I add the sawdust, we can already see some voltage in the voltmeter. This is because the sawdust gets between these two plates and makes sure that these plates don't touch each other or, you know, create a short circuit. But the text mentions adding yet another strange material to complete the battery, the neck of a peacock. In the ancient Sanskrit text, this material is mentioned as chikigriva, which means the neck of a peacock. Many secret cults exist even today, and these people are trying to recreate the battery using the actual neck of the peacock. But this is a mistake, because all ancient texts, especially those related to alchemy, use code words to confuse the public. Even Isaac Newton mentions using green lime, and experts are trying to figure out what he actually meant. In ancient Indian alchemy, the neck of the peacock actually refers to copper sulfate solution, which is what I have here. You can see that both of them have the same color. And I'm going to add the copper sulfate solution into the container. And you can see that as soon as they add this, there is a dramatic increase in voltage. Here, it's showing me more than 1 volt. So you can see that what's mentioned in the ancient text is actually capable of making electricity. Remember, we read in history books that the electric battery was created just 200 years ago by a man called Alessandro Volta, but Sage Agastya created this battery at least 4,000 years ago. But what's really strange is that Alessandro Volta uses pretty much the same materials for creating the quote-unquote very first battery. He uses copper, zinc, and instead of using copper sulfate, he uses sulfuric acid. Now, going back to the ancient text, Agastya says, use 100 containers and you can create a very effective force. Here, you can see that I've used 3 pots in series, and you can see that the voltage increases up to more than 3 volts. Now, if I connect a small LED bulb, let's see if it works. There you go. You see, the small LED bulb actually glows with just 3 of these pots. This is a very interesting point that the ancient text mentions using multiple cells in series to increase the voltage. The natural question is, why was this used? Why did ancient people use multiple containers to produce high voltage electricity? Did they use it for lighting purposes, just like modern days. If so, is there any evidence that the electric bulbs were used in ancient times? In the Dendera Temple of ancient Egypt, there are strange carvings which show the usage of electric bulbs. These carvings were also created 4,000 years ago, and you can see these huge electric bulbs with snake-like filaments inside. What's more interesting is that there are wires coming out of these bulbs and going into a box. Did this box contain Agastya's battery of 100 cells producing 100 volts to illuminate these bulbs? If this is true, this might explain how ancient structures like Giza Pyramid and Kailasa Temple were constructed in such a short span of time. If we visit the Kailasa Temple, for example, the chambers inside are so dark that nothing is visible. There's no way to use mirrors or metal sheets to reflect the sunlight into these chambers for illumination. But there are spectacular, flawless carvings on the ceilings and on the walls inside these dark chambers. Creating such brilliant carvings is impossible with flickering flames of natural fire. How was it possible without the use of steady electric light? If we assume that ancient people did use torches and light from fire for creating this temple and carvings, there should be a lot of soot or carbon deposited on the ceilings, but there's no trace of soot or carbon on the ceilings at all. How do we explain the creation of these brilliant monuments? Is it possible that the ancient people were using battery-powered lights? How else do we explain this ancient battery mentioned thousands of years ago by Agastya? Agastya actually explained many advanced technical devices in the same book. He talks about battery-powered vehicles. Today, we have electric bikes which use just 24 volts. The text mentions electroplating, which can be done easily with this setup. He talks about splitting water into oxygen and hydrogen and using this hydrogen in balloons for traveling. And we do hot air balloon rides today. Interestingly, he also talks about the concept of an electric motor. Now, I've connected 5 of these cells, and here you can see there's enough power to charge a cell phone, and we can even run a motor. Now, this is really fascinating because once we realize that these type of gadgets were used in ancient times, we can understand how ancient temples like Hoysaleswara Temple were built. I've shown you the machine-made pillars in this temple, and even archaeologists agree that these were made using lathe technology. If Agastya's batteries and motors were used along with the gears and machine tools carved on the Hoysaleswara Temple, we can easily produce these machine-made pillars. Now, why did Agastya use earthen pots instead of other items? If he could use metals like copper and zinc, he could have easily used these metals, wood or glass, for the container. The reason for using earthen pots is this. It cools what's inside by a process called evaporative cooling. The efficiency of the battery dramatically changes with its temperature, so the earthen pot will keep the battery at its optimal temperature. If these earthen pot batteries were used in large numbers in ancient times, we should have found at least a few of them. Believe it or not, archaeologists have unearthed thousands of these pots in varying sizes all over India. The usual theory is that these pots were used for burying dead people, but they've also excavated many, many pots which don't contain human remains, but have metal plates instead. For example, in the village of Chandaya, several pots were unearthed with copper plates inside them. Archaeologists estimate that these are also 4,000 years old, which matches the timeline of sage Agastya. Are all these evidences just coincidences? The ancient battery that can light up a light bulb, the electric bulb carved in ancient Egypt, carvings in the dark chambers of Kailasa Temple with absolutely no natural light, today's motors running using just 5 of these cells, machine-made pillars of Hoysaleswara Temple, thousands of excavated earthen pots with copper and metal plates. Are all these evidences mere coincidences, or do they prove that ancient civilizations used advanced technology? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like and share this video with your friends, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.